Hi, this is B. Charanjeevara. In this video lesson, I would like to teach the standing waves formed in closed argon pipes and open argon pipes. See, what is a closed argon pipe? Suppose, if you see this pipe, just imagine this is a pipe and this has one side open. This is open and the other side is closed. So, this pipe, if I just create some disturbance in the air filled in this pipe, if I just create a disturbance because of resonance, you will listen a loud sound. So this is how the air enclosed in this pipe will disturb. So the way in which the disturbance occur, how the waves, standing waves form in this type of pipes, argon pipes. This type of pipe is called closed argon pipe. Say for example sunlight. When you are blowing sunlight, and it is also nothing but closed argon pipe. Now let us see how these waves are formed in the closed argon pipe. See, we can consider this is a closed argon pipe. One side it is closed and the other side it is open. So this is the closed end and this is the open end. Suppose if it is enclosed with air molecules like this. Suppose if this is enclosed with air molecules like this at different positions in our consideration. If you observe this particular position, this is open end. If you create a disturbance here, what happens? The degree of freedom is more, hence this can vibrate this way in the forward direction and reflected back and moves in the reverse direction, backward direction. So it moves in the forward direction, all the particles they move in the forward direction, and as a result of that, every particle will move with a less displacement. See, this is very, very less. And almost its displacement become less. And the displacement of this becomes zero. So degree of freedom is very, very less, almost a zero at this closed end. This is the closed end, closed side of the pipe. This is closed end. So the degree of freedom of the vibration of the molecules in the pipe are zero. That's why they cannot move. The net displacement of the particles lies on the closed end almost as zero. So when you are imagining that when a disturbance is created, they move with what displacement? Since the particles lies at the open edge, open end of the pipe, they have more degree of freedom, hence they move with more displacement. So if you observe the displacement versus the position of the particles, I just write down here, if this particle is moving in the x forward direction, I write here for this particular particles, the displacement in this direction is this one. And for this one will be somewhere here, it will be a little bit less than this, and for displacement this will be less, and for this, and for this, and for this zero. So if you imagine that these curve represents like this, so I just write down this is the displacement of this one and this is the displacement of this one, and this is how in the positive x-axis. While they are coming back and they are reflected back, since this is a closed end and they reverse by 5 degrees of phase, and as they come back and this is how they come back with increasing displacement. They just come back with increasing displacement and reverse by phase angle pi as they are reflected at a rigid boundary. So the degree of freedom is more at this end. That is why the displacement is more and the reversed by pi degrees of its phase. So you can just write down the displacement in the reverse way will be like this, and this will be like this, and you can just write down this is the waveform under our consideration. So this is the waveform, create a waveform like this, and this waveform has a wavelength of lambda by 4. So the length of this air column, in the first mode of vibration, it creates one antinode. This is antinode, and this is node, and this open end, always at open end it forms antinode, always at closed end it forms node, because the degree of freedom is almost a zero, and the degree of freedom to vibrate the particles at open end is maximum. That is why it forms antinode and node. So this is the minimum wavelength with which it can form a stationary wave and which give a certain note. This note is called fundamental note, or the frequency corresponding to this first mode of vibration is called the fundamental frequency. So I just write down the length of this particular wave, first mode of vibration, is equal to lambda by 4. Therefore, the lambda in this case, first mode of vibration, is equal to 4L. So that is why the frequency corresponding to this particular first mode of vibration is called the fundamental frequency of closed argon pipe. So now let us derive the expression for closed argon pipe. Fundamental frequency of closed argon pipe. Simply I write here closed pipe. So we know pretty well that velocity of sound is equal to L lambda, and in this case frequency is equal to V by lambda. So in the first mode of vibration, N is equal to V by, instead of lambda we can write down 4L. So the fundamental frequency is equal to N is equal to V by 4L in case of a closed pipe. So this is the frequency with which the air column in the closed pipe it vibrates, which is equal to 1/4 of the wavelength. That is why we can write down the fundamental frequency is equal to V by 4L. So this is what is called first harmonic. This frequency is called first harmonic. This is also called first harmonic. And now let us see what will be the next type of vibrations. In the same time, there is a possibility of occurring the different notes for the same given length. Let us see what will be the next stage of vibration. Now let us see. In the first case, we have already derived the frequency of the fundamental note in case of a closed organ pipe as N is equal to V by 4L. This is what we have derived. And in this case, there is one antinode and one node. And in the immediate second mode of vibration, there are two nodes. This is one node and this is another node. There is a second possibility with which it can vibrate. So, what is the length of the air column? L is equal to 3 lambda over 4, 3 times lambda by 4. And hence, lambda in this case is 4L by 3. Now, let us see what will be the frequency corresponding to this second mode of vibration. In the second mode of vibration. Or this is also called first overtone. First overtone. Always the first one is called fundamental frequency. This is fundamental mode. And the frequency corresponding to this is first harmonic. This is called first harmonic. And the second stage is second mode of vibration, this one, in which there are two nodes and there are two antinodes are formed here. So, in this case, we want to find the frequency. I write here the first overtone N1 is equal to V by lambda. That is equal to, instead of lambda, we can write down 4L by 3. So, this becomes 3 times V by 4L. Now, you can write down the frequency. In this case, the second mode of vibration, first overtone frequency is equal to 3 times its fundamental frequency. So, this is what is called the frequency of the first overtone and the third harmonic. This is what is called third harmonic. So, we can write down this is first overtone or third harmonic. See, in the first we obtained first mode of vibration, we got first harmonic. And the immediate mode of vibration, we are able to get only third mode. In this case, the second harmonic is absent. We cannot get the second harmonic in case of this closed organ pipe. So, now let us see the third mode of vibration. In the case of third mode of vibration, in this case, how many nodes are there? 3 nodes are there. And how many antinodes are there? 1, 2, 3. 3 antinodes are there. Then what is the length of the air column? In this case, length is equal to 5 lambda by 4. So, lambda is equal to 4L by 5. As you know, the frequency corresponding to this third mode of vibration in this case we have 1, 2, 3, 3 nodes and 1, 2, 3, 3 antinodes and length of the air column is 5 lambda by 4, hence lambda is equal to 4L by 5. So, we know that frequency is equal to V by lambda, but this is the second overtone, third mode of vibration or second overtone. And now let us find the value of n2. Instead of lambda, you substitute here 4L by 5. We will get 5 multiplied by V by 4L. So in this case, n2 is equal to 5N. So we got fifth harmonic. This is what is called fifth harmonic. So I write here in this mode, we got only fifth harmonic. So with the closed pipe, we will get only the fifth harmonic. All odd harmonics are available in case of the closed organ pipe. So in case of closed organ pipe, in the first mode of vibration, we get the first harmonic, that is fundamental frequency, and the second mode of vibration, our first overtone, we get third harmonic. In the third mode of vibration, we get the fifth harmonic. So we get all odd multiples of the harmonics are available. All even numbered multiples of harmonics are not available. For example, sa, re is not possible. Ga, ma is not possible. So alternative, all odd multiples are available in case of this closed organ pipe. So the relation between the fundamental frequency and the different mode of vibrations is harmonics is equal to n is to n1 is to n2 is to n3 is to and so on is equal to 1 is to 3 is to 5 is to 7 is to and so on. So this is the first fundamental frequency, and this is first overtone or third harmonic, and this is the second overtone or fifth harmonic, and this is the third overtone or seventh harmonic. See, once you know, you want to find the frequency corresponding to the second overtone. So second overtone frequency is equal to 5n, 5 times of the fundamental frequency. So this is the ratio in case of the closed organ pipes. Now let us see what will be the fundamental frequency and other frequency of overtones in case of the open organ pipe. So the standing waves formed in open organ pipe. If the pipe is open both the ends, if a pipe is open both the ends, and this is open and this is also open. So if the pipe is open both the ends, the pipe is called open pipe. Now let us see, this is the open pipe. So we can consider that this is open pipe. See, both the sides kept open. And it has both the sides the maximum degree of freedom. So the molecules are the air particles in the medium. Just they vibrate with maximum displacement at both the ends. Whereas with the zero displacement at its center. So degree of freedom is at the center is zero, and the degree of freedom is increasing towards the edges, towards the open edge, open end. Now the degree of freedom at this is more, and it vibrates with maximum displacement, possible displacement. Hence it forms at the edge is antinode. Similarly, here also it forms antinode, and the degree of freedom is more at the open end, and it just vibrates with the maximum displacement. And similarly, when you are going towards the center of the pipe, and the displacement will be decreased in the decreasing order, and the displacement will be decreased and finally become zero. And this is how, when these two move in opposite directions, when this is moving in this way, this will come to this way. This way. This is how they move. So in this way, you just imagine this particular region is almost all formed node. And if you observe the graph, the displacement in this forward direction is gradually decreasing toward the center. So what happened now? The displacements are gradually decreasing in its order. So the maximum displacement at this particular position, and the displacement is decreased, while come to this point again decrease, and almost all displacement becomes zero. And if you observe here, the displacement in the opposite direction, it is less, like this. And if you observe here, it just become a little bit more. And when you come to this end, in the opposite direction, it become more. This is how. And for another direction, it comes in the reverse way, like this. And you will be getting a wave like this. And the other end. So, this is how you will get a stationary wave in such a way, with minimum one node and with two antinodes. So this is how, this is the way in which they vibrate like this. And this particular region, they vibrate more. And when you come to this particular layer, the vibrations are just a little bit less than the first one. And while very close to the center part, central region, the displacement is very, very less. And when it is exactly at center, the degree of freedom becomes zero and it forms a node. So at the edges, we have antinodes. At the center, we have node. So this is the minimum wavelength with which it forms the fundamental node. That is why the length of this pipe, I just write here, length of the air column is equal to lambda by 2. And this way we can write down lambda is equal to 2L. In this open argon pipe, this is the first mode of fundamental mode of vibration. In this fundamental mode of vibration, we have two antinodes and one node. And the length of the air column vibrating in the pipe, in the first mode of vibration, it is possible with which the length of the air column is half of its wavelength. See, lambda is equal to 2 times of the length. Now we can find the fundamental frequency of this first mode of vibration. So this is first mode of vibration. This is first mode of vibration in case of open argon pipe. This is also called fundamental mode. This is also called fundamental mode. And the frequency corresponding to this is called fundamental frequency. Fundamental frequency. So this fundamental frequency, according to the formula V is equal to L lambda, where velocity of the wave is equal to L lambda, where N is equal to V by lambda. But in the first mode vibration, lambda is equal to 2L. Therefore, fundamental frequency in the open pipe, n is equal to V by 2L. This is the formula for the fundamental frequency of the open pipe. This is also called first harmonic. This frequency is also called, this note is also called first harmonic or fundamental frequency. This is how the waves form, the stationary or standing waves form in the open pipe. Now let us see what will be the next mode of vibration immediately. At the same time we can listen for the same length with different notes. Let us see what will be the next second mode of vibration. That is also called the frequency corresponding to first power tone. Now let us see. Already we have discussed the fundamental frequency of open pipe is n equal to V by 2L. This is also called first harmonic. And now let us go to the next mode of vibration, that is second mode of vibration. In this mode, we have 1, 2 nodes and 1, 2, 3. Three antinodes are there. So the length corresponding to this air column, L is equal to lambda, or simply 2 lambda by 2. So this is 1 lambda by 2 and this is another lambda by 2. So 2 lambda by 2, L is equal to lambda. So we know the frequency is equal to V by lambda. But n is equal, I write here, this is frequency corresponding to first power term. That is why I write here n1. N1 is equal to V by lambda. So that is equal to V by, in this case, lambda can be written as 2 times to the top 2L. So this frequency n is equal to 2 times of fundamental frequency. So this is what is called the second harmonic. This is what is called second harmonic. So second mode of vibration corresponds to first power tone, or we can also write down this as second harmonic. Now, so second harmonic is available in the case of open pipe, but second harmonic is not available in case of closed pipe. That is the difference between these two. And in the third mode of vibration, if you observe, this is what is called second power tone. In this case, you see the degree of freedom is always maximum at both the ends. So here it forms antinode and node, antinode, node, antinode, node and antinode. So 1, 2, 3, 4 antinodes and 3 nodes are formed in this case. And length of the air column is equal to 3 lambda by 4. This is 1 lambda by 2 and this is another lambda by 2 and this is another. So 3 lambda by 2. There are 3 lambda by 2. So lambda is equal to 2L by 3. You know, the second power tone frequency is equal to V by lambda. So that is equal to V by, you can write down lambda is equal to 2L by 3. So I write here, this is 3 times V by 2L. 3 times V by 2L. So N2 frequency of the second power tone is 3 times the fundamental frequency. So this is what is called third harmonic. This is what is called third harmonic. Third harmonic. So in case of open argon pipe, we can get all harmonic, integral multiples of all harmonics are available. First harmonic, second harmonic, third harmonic, fourth harmonic. This is first harmonic, this is second harmonic, and this is third, four, five, six, and so on. Just like in a stretched string. So you can, they all notes are available. Sa, ri, ga, ma, pa, da, ni, sa, every, without missing any note. So almost all notes are available in case of the open organ pipe. Now let us see the difference among stretched strings and open pipe, closed pipe. The ratios of frequencies, fundamental frequencies to the immediate overtones in case of open organ pipe. N1:N2:N3:, and so on, is equal to 1:2:3:4, and so on. So all integral multiples of the harmonics are available in case of the open organ pipe. This is similar to that of the stretched string in. This is similar to that of a stretched string. In a stretched string, the fundamental frequency is equal to 1/2L under root to T over mu. So the fundamental frequency, and in the case of stretched string, see these two, the length is equal to lambda by 2. Length is equal to length of the string, the length of the air column in this case. So just you compare these two. In case of second mode of vibration for the same length, there is a possibility of formation of the string with two loops. So in this case, the first overtone is equal to 2 times to that of the fundamental frequency. In this case, lambda is equal to L equal to lambda. This is the first mode of second mode of vibration or first overtone. Then you compare these two, which are equal. And now let us go to the third mode of vibration, where you will be getting one note, one, this is how, three loops. Here you are getting three loops. So length corresponding to this is 3λ/2, and the frequency corresponding to this is 3N. So just like in an open organ pipe, you can compare this with the frequencies in stretched strings. So even in stretched string, you have fundamental frequency to its overtone frequencies are in the ratio 1:2:3:4. That means all harmonics are available in case of the stretched string and in case of open organ pipe. But in case of the closed organ pipe, only in closed organ pipe, the frequency ratio N1:N2:N3 is equal to 1:3:5:7, and so on. So only odd multiples of harmonics are available in case of closed pipe, closed organ pipe. So these are the different differences observed in case of the stretched string, as far as compared with stretched strings, are almost all equal to that of open organ pipe. And in case of closed organ pipe, we will get only odd multiples of R harmonics. Now you carefully listen the comparative observation in case of stretched string, open pipe and closed pipe. See, in this case, fundamental frequency is equal to 1/2L under root T over mu, tension and linear density of the wire. In this case, velocity of sound in air by length of the air column. This is in case of open pipe, V/2L. and in case of closed pipe, fundamental frequency is equal to V by 4L. So this is the related figure. The first power tone in case of stretched string, it is also second harmonic, N1 is equal to 2N. In case of the open pipe, N1 is equal to 2N, so both are same. And in case of closed pipe, there is no presence of second harmonic. Directly we are obtaining third harmonic immediately after fundamental frequency. So there is no possibility of getting the even numbered harmonics in case of this closed pipe. And in case of open pipe, we can get all the integral multiples of the frequencies. Even also it is true in case of stretched strings. So in case of closed pipe, in the second overtone, N2 is equal to 3N. This is the third harmonic. This is also third harmonic. And in this closed pipe, you don't get fourth harmonic. Immediately you will get fifth harmonic. So this is all the comparative observations of the three types of the stationary waves formed in three stretched string, open pipe and closed pipe. Now let us find the velocity of sound in air using resonance tube. See, we can use the resonance tube. This is what is called resonance tube. It is of 1 meter long pipe which is transparent, and this is to be filled with water, and this is open one side and closed the other side, connected to a rubber tube, and the another end of the rubber tube connected to a reservoir. So the reservoir is filled with water along with the tube. What is this resonance tube? And this resonance tube has mounted with a 1 meter scale, and all these arrangement connected to a vertical stand. And now if a tuning fork is just excited or hit with a rubber hammer and keep horizontally in the, as shown in the figure, then what happen? The vibrations of the tuning fork will just create a disturbance in the air column of this tube. This is the air column up to this particular part is air column. This air is filled in this. This air start vibrations, and when the tuning fork is excited in the tube, if the frequency of this is N, the natural frequency of the tuning fork is N, then it creates a disturbance in the resonance tube. The air in the resonance tube produce a stationary wave. The first mode of stationary wave, L1 is lambda by 4, as we know. L1 is lambda by 4. And the frequency corresponding to the vibrations of this air column and the natural frequency of the tuning fork, when these two become equal, you will get a loud sound. This situation is called resonance. The natural frequency or the fundamental frequency, first mode of vibration of the air column with which it is vibrating, and the natural frequency of the tuning fork, when they become equal, then the phenomenon of resonance occurs. So the sound vibrates with maximum amplitude. This particular stage is called resonance. So in the first stage, first resonance condition, we will get the length of the air column. So the length of this air column can be measured by lowering the reservoir or moving up the reservoir. You can change the liquid level in the resonance tube. So this particular length, say at a particular stage, you will get the first mode of vibration, and it gives a loud sound. This is called resonant sound, and the length corresponding to this air column, we can obtain this with the help of the scale fixed at the adjacent side to that of this tube. So the length of this air column can be measured L1. Say for example, L1 is 16 centimeters. And immediately if you lower the reservoir, you can decrease the level of the water in the tube, and at a particular position you will be getting another stage where you will get loud sound. In this case, we will be getting a stationary wave like this. You will be getting a loud sound. So this length is corresponds to L2 is equal to 3 lambda by 4, this length. So in the first length, you are getting one resonance sound, a loud sound, and at the second stage immediately, the successive loud sound will occur at 3 lambda by 4. Suppose if it is L1 is some 16 centimeters, then at what position it will occur at 48 centimeters. At immediately 48 centimeters, you will be observing a loud sound. So there are two successive resonating sounds. So the difference between these two lengths, L1 is equal to lambda by 4, L2 is equal to 3 lambda by 4, and L2 minus L1 is equal to lambda by 2. So lambda is equal to wavelength in this air column is equal to 2 into L2 minus L1. As you know, velocity of sound is equal to n lambda. So V is equal to 2n into L2 minus L1. Now, using this formula, we can determine the velocity of sound in air at room temperature. See, what is this n? This is the natural frequency of this tuning fork. Say this tuning fork may have some value such as 512 Hz. So once you know the value of this frequency, n is equal to 512 Hz, L1 is equal to 16 centimeters, L2 is equal to 48 centimeters, then it is very easy to find the velocity of sound in air. V is equal to 2 into, where n equal to 512 into, what is L1, L2? L2 is 48. L2 is 48 centimeters minus L1 is how much? 16 centimeters. So this comes 2 into 512 into 48 minus 16 is equal to 32. So this comes the value around. Now this value becomes 32,768 centimeters per second. So this is equal to 327.68 meters per second. This is how we can determine the value of the velocity of sound in room temperature. And now let us see the waves formed not exactly from the open end. The stationary wave will form a little bit above the open end. So we have to measure this. We are not measuring this particular part of the length. Now we have to consider this as E. This is the part above the open end, which is not taken into consideration. We are just considering only the wave from its open edge. We are measuring the length of the air column. But it is not like that. The air column will form just a little bit above the open end of the tube. So we have to take this also into consideration, E. This is what is called end correction. This end correction is equal to, E is equal to, say for the first one. For the first one, this is L1 plus E. For the first one, L1 plus E is equal to lambda by 4. In the second case, L2 plus E is equal to 3 lambda by 4. So for length L1, you have to add E, that is equal to lambda by 4. For the second stage of resonance air column, V we have to consider L2 plus E, that is equal to 3 lambda by 4. And if you just take the equation for lambda and just you eliminate lambda, you will get E is equal to L2 minus 3 L1 by 2. This is what is called the end correction. Then this is equal to 0.61 times the radius of the inner radius of the tube. This is the radius of the tube, this particular part. This is the radius of the tube, inner radius of the tube. So the end correction is equal to 0.61 times the radius, inner radius of the tube. This is for this open end. This is what is the end correction in case of closed pipe. If it is in case of open pipe, we have to consider both the sides and the end correction will become twice to that of the end correction existed in the closed pipe. So in case of this, we are getting end correction is equal to 0.61 times the radius, inner radius of the tube. This is how we have to determine the end correction of the resonance apparatus. Now let us solve one problem. You see, a vertical tube is made to stand in water so that the water level can be adjusted. Sound waves of frequency 320 Hz are sent into the top of the tube if standing waves are produced at two successive water levels of 20 cm and 73 cm. What is the speed of sound waves in A in the tube? So first of all, you have to understand that a tube can be adjusted in water. A vertical tube made to stand in water so that the water level can be adjusted. So you can just keep the tube like this. So the water level can be adjusted by dipping it or by raising. And now when a tuning fork is hit here, with what frequency? 320 Hz. Then what happened? First of all, a standing wave is formed at what level? 20 centimeters. And the next resonating stays occur at 73 centimeters. Then we have to determine the velocity of sound or speed of sound in the air. So first of all, while solving the problem, we have to see what is the data given and what are the units given. This is most important. So we have to convert always the units into SI system. So the given data is, the frequency of the tuning fork is given 320 Hz. This is SI unit. And L1, L2. L1 is given in centimeters, but we have to convert this into meters. So this can be written as 20 into 10 power of minus 2 meters. And again, the second length is equal to, we have to convert this into meters, 73 into 10 power of minus 2 meters. Then what you have to determine the speed of sound in air column, air. So what is the necessary formula you require? The second stage is formula. So velocity is equal to 2n into L2 minus L1 is the formula. Then what you have to do, the next stage is final stage is, you have to substitute and you have to calculate the value. V is equal to 2 times the frequency of the tuning fork is given, 320 multiplied by L2 minus L1, 73 into 10 power minus 2 minus 20 into 10 power of minus 2. Now, after simplification, you will be getting 33,920 centimeter into 10 power of minus 2 meter per second. We already converted into meter per second. So what is the value of this? 339.2 meters per second is the velocity of sound in this case in the tube. So this is how we have to solve the problem. And now let us see the next problem regarding open pipe and closed pipe. Now let us see the another problem. A closed argon pipe 70 centimeters long is sounded. If the velocity of sound is 331 meters per second, what is the fundamental frequency of vibration of air column? So in this problem, we have to observe the given data. Length of the air column is given. It's a closed pipe. It is a closed pipe. And for a fundamental frequency, we have to observe the first mode of vibration. So this is the first mode of vibration for which length is given. How much? 70 centimeters. But this is given in CGS system, whereas velocity is given in SI units. So we have to convert this into meters. 70 into 10 power of minus 2 meters. See, there is a common mistake everybody is doing. Directly they substitute the value, but we have to see, always we have to convert the units into a common unit, that is SI unit. So the centimeter is to be converted into meter. V is given 331 meter per second, and we have to determine the frequency. So what is the formula related to this closed pipe fundamental frequency? N equal to V by 4L. In this case, N is equal to V by 4L. This is the formula you have to write. And calculation, substitution and calculation. So the velocity is given 331 meters per second by 4 times its length. That is comes 118.2 H. You have to mention the unit is most important. Without unit or a physical quantity, there is no meaning. And you have to see that if you should be very particular about the applying the proper unit. So this is the one type of problem. Now let us see another problem. See, in this problem, a metal bar when clamped at its center resonates in the fundamental frequency with longitudinal waves of frequency 4 kilohertz. If the clamp is moved to one end, what will be its fundamental resonance frequency? See, in the first case, a clamp is set at the center of the wire and the longitudinal waves are produced. And when it is set at the center, it can be considered like this, and the length of the wire will be equal to half of the wavelength. So lambda is equal to 2L in this case, and the frequency of vibration of this is equal to longitudinal wave is equal to V by L, that is equal to V by 2L, that is given 4 kilohertz. And in the next case, the clamp is moved to one end, the another end. Then what happened? It just behaves like closed pipe. So in this case, the fundamental frequency is equal to V by lambda dash, new one. This is lambda dash. So I write here lambda dash. So this can be written as V by 4L, because lambda dash is 4L. But we can write down this half of V by 2L. Therefore, this become 2 kilohertz. So the frequency reduced to half by shifting this clamp to another end. So this is the way in which we can solve this type of problem. Now there is one more problem. A string has a length of 0.4 meters and a mass of 0.16 grams. If the tension in the string is 70 newtons, what are the three lowest frequencies it produces when plucked it? So this is the problem given, and now we have to observe that a string is to be plucked. When it is plucked, the lowest frequency is the fundamental frequency, that is n is equal to 1 by 2 l under root t by mu. And we have to find the next immediate frequency. The next immediate frequency is with two loops. So this is the next frequency with which it vibrates. If the frequency of this is n, this frequency is 2n. And the third one is, we have to observe that it has to vibrate with three loops. So it has to vibrate with three loops like this. And its frequency is 3n. So in general, for any number of loops, p loops, there are p loops, one loop, two loop, three loops, and so on, p loops, then the frequency can be written as p by 2l into under root t over mu. This is the general formula for any p loops. But here, when the string is plucked, what is the length of the string? It is given 0.4 meters. What is the mass of the total string? 0.16 grams. See, it is given grams. This is CGS unit. You have to convert this into MKS unit immediately. So we have to write down this as 0.16 into 10 power of minus 3 kilograms. Immediately you have to convert this into kilograms. And tension is given in newtons, 70 newtons. So now we have to find the linear density. Linear density of the string is equal to total mass by total length. Total mass by total length is equal to 0.16 in 10 power minus 3 kilograms by total length is 0.4. So you will be getting the mass per unit length. That is linear density. So what is the mass per unit length? 0.4 in 10 power minus 3. Kilogram per meter. Every meter wire has a mass of 0.4 into 10 power minus 3 kilograms. Now, we are going to the three lowest frequencies. The three lowest means first fundamental frequency, next immediate first overtone, and then second overtone, or first harmonic, second harmonic, third harmonic. So, what is the first fundamental frequency? 1 by 2 L root over T by mu. So now let us substitute the value. 2 into 0.4 is the length in meters under root 70 in newtons by in kilograms per meter. So all these are in SI units. So the final answer is 523 H. So once you know the fundamental frequency, you can express in terms of the overtones, because all the integral multiples of the fundamental frequency will give the next immediate harmonic or the overtones. So the next second lowest one, first lowest, second lowest is the first overtone, that is equal to 2n, 2 into fundamental frequency. So you are getting 10 1046 h. And the next, the third one, n3 is equal to 3n. So 3 into 523. So 1569 H. So these are the three frequencies, lowest frequencies you can obtain by stretching this string.